Welcome to the demonstration, Accessing ELA, Math and Science, Summative Assessment Results in CERS Video. This video is part of a series of microlearning style videos from the introduction to the California Educator Reporting System, or CERS for Teachers. A resource guide accompanies this video series and can be accessed in the description of this video. In this demonstration, I will be entering the CERS sandbox by selecting the role sample middle school teacher. I will select the Enter Sandbox button. The assigned group section is in the center of the homepage. If you log in to your live CERS environment and you do not see any groups, please contact your site administrator or your LEA assessment coordinator to have those groups assigned to you through rostering, which is also called Manage Student Groups in CERS. I will select the sample middle school grade 8 group, which brings me to the results view for this group. I will click the plus icon to see the full list of available assessments. For this demonstration, I will select the grade 8 ELA summative and I will deselect the assessment that was the default. Once selected, I am able to see the overall results for the group. I can see the number of results, the overall scale score, which is 2593, and the student score distribution, which shows what percent of my students fell into each of the achievement levels: standard exceeded, level 4, standard met, level 3, standard nearly met, level 2, and standard not met, level 1. I have the ability to change the display value from a percent to a number by selecting the number button. I can also export these results at any time by selecting the Export CSV button. This will download a CSV file to my desktop. If I want to see more detail about the student's results, I can select the Show Results link under the student score distribution. From here, I can view the results by student. Selecting any of the headers in this view will sort the results by that column. Clicking a second time will sort in the opposite direction. For the ELA summative, we will see the achievement level and scale score for each student. Since we have selected the ELA summative assessment, we can change the results by student view to writing trait scores. Because this is a sandbox, you will see all of the available genres. In the live CERS environment, you will only see the genres available to the grade level of students selected. On the left are the categories for the score: evidence elaboration, organization purpose, and conventions. Then we can see the average score for each category, as well as the percent of students that scored each of the available point values. There is another view available to us for the ELA summative assessment, and that is the target reports. Target reports are also available for the math summative assessment. We can see target reports only if we have 30 or more students in our student group. For this report, we can view the target and how the students scored in that target in comparison to the entire test. We will also see performance relative to the assessment in its entirety. We also have the Lexile report view available for ELA. This would be quantile if we had the math summative selected. Here, we can see the Lexile measure and Lexile range. As always, I can export these results at any time by selecting the Export CSV button. This will download a CSV file to my desktop. I will now log out of the sandbox and re-enter using the role of sample high school teacher. I will select the Enter Sandbox button. I will select the sample high school grade 11 group, which brings me to the results view for this group. I will click the plus icon to see the full list of available assessments. For this demonstration, I will select the grade 11 CAST summative, and I will deselect the assessment that was the default. Once selected, I am able to see the overall results for the group. I can see the number of results, the overall scale score, which is 597, and the student score distribution, which shows what percent of my students fell into each of the achievement levels. Standard exceeded, level 4. Standard met, level 3. Standard nearly met, level 2. And standard not met, level 1. I have the ability to change the display value from a percent to a number by selecting the number button. I can also export these results at any time by selecting the Export CSV button. This will download a CSV file to my desktop. And for the CAST, we have the ability to view results overall, but also to view results by domain. This will organize results by life sciences, physical sciences, and earth and space sciences. I get the percent of students in each of the three levels for each domain. Again, if I want to see more detail about the student results, I can select the Show Results link under the student score distribution. From here, I can view the results by student. Selecting any of the headers in this view will sort the results by that column. Clicking a second time will sort in the opposite direction. There is a common question about summative assessment results. How long after test administration will summative ELA, mathematics, and science results show in CERS? The answer has two parts. The Smarter Balance summative assessments for ELA and math and the California science test are usually released in late May. And the results for the California Spanish assessment and the California alternate assessments for ELA, math, and science are usually available in September due to post-equating. Another common question about results in CERS is, how do educators access target reports for Smarter Balance summative assessments if the group has less than 30 students? Since the target reports in CERS require a minimum of 30 students, it is recommended to create a group of at least 30 students to be able to access target reports. There is one more common question about summative assessment results. Will teachers have access to results for their students from last year and for their students in the current year? Since student groups are automatically reset each summer, the answer is yes, if both groups of students have been rostered to the teacher within the current year. This rostering process is completed by an administrator. So, multiple groups can be assigned to any teacher by an administrator setting up the student groups. For example, there can be one group with the current students and another that has students from last year. This way, teachers can see the results for the students they taught the previous year, as well as the results for the students currently in their classroom. So now it's your turn to explore. First, you will want to locate the instructions and the link to the sandbox, both of which are in the resource guide, which accompanies this series of microlearning videos. When you start your exploration, be sure to access the sandbox using a teacher role. Remember, since this is a sandbox, you can't break anything and the data will look different when you log into your actual CERS environment. You may do one or all of the following tasks: search results for a student, search results for a group, create a printable report, export a CSV file, create a custom group, and for CAST, find those achievement levels by domain. Smarter Balance ELA, we can find the writing trait scores or those target reports. And as you explore the sandbox and the summative ELA math and science data, we have questions to consider. How might you use the summative data from CERS alongside other data to inform those next steps in your LEA? Who needs this information and how will you share it? This is your time to explore the sandbox. Thank you for watching this demonstration of accessing ELA, math, and science summative assessment results in CERS. We hope you found the information to be useful. The full video series title list is located in the description of this video.